This is a great day, clear day, and it will be clear because of the efforts that are brought forth in developing this emissions control area with regard to our shipping.
Ports like the one behind me both drive both the global and local economies. As the world marketplaces have grown, ports have moved billions of dollars in raw materials and products and created thousands of jobs. But we've seen for some time that the constant traffic of ocean-going vessels has brought with it some very serious challenges. In this area alone, more than 6.5 million people are exposed to elevated concentrations of diesel fuel emissions.
Pollution from a ship docked right here is inhaled by school children, not just here at Newark, but also by children hundreds of miles away.
Cities that make their livelihoods from this industry are prone to suffer inordinately high rates of cancer, asthma, and other diseases. Children in these communities feel the effects of pollution in the air they breathe and the water they drink. Residents and workers bear the brunt of harmful emissions and dangerous toxins. And the greatest burden of the emissions from ocean-going vessels falls disproportionately on low-income and minority households. Now, some American ports are expecting to double or even triple their traffic in the coming years. Right now, it is important that we step up to protect human health and the environment. Last Friday, we submitted a proposal to the International Maritime Organization to designate a 200-mile wide buffer zone around our coast, a distance of protection that will help air quality improvements reach as far inland as Kansas.
EPA charts a course today that will protect millions of people from the dangerous pollution from ocean-going vessels. EPA's application for an emissions control area means that foreign flagships within American waters will soon be required to greatly reduce the pollution they produce, a pollution that jeopardizes the health and lives of people living thousands of miles inland.
We are absolutely committed to making sure that we take every step possible, whether it is on trucks and cars, or whether it is on ships and boats, whether it's in the Port Authority of New York, New Jersey, or down in Camden, all across the state, that we are doing those things that will protect our citizens.
Beginning in 2011, nitrogen oxide emissions will be cut by 20% from all new and existing vessels built since 1990. By 2016, all engines will see a cut of 80%. By 2015, sulfur emissions from fuel will be down 95% and small particulate matter by 85%. This is an important and long overdue step to protect air and water along our shores and the health of people throughout the country. We're here to send a powerful signal to the world that we can ensure the economic strength of our port cities at the same time that we take responsible steps to protect health and the environment.